The failure to remain committed to the Constitution, as demonstrated by the court's jurisprudence on Article 21, is becoming increasingly visible. In the face of the colossal public health crisis caused by COVID-19, the lives of migrant laborers have turned upside down. They have no work, no source of income, no access to basic necessities, and no means to reach home. Instead of taking on petitions questioning the situation, for the longest time, the court refused to admit or adjourn these petitions. In rejecting or adjourning these petitions, the court made several questionable remarks. It said that the government's already provided laborers with 2 square meals a day, so what more could they possibly need? And that incidents like the horrific accident where migrant laborers sleeping on the railway tracks were killed could not be avoided, because how can such things be stopped? Many of the so-called excuses of the court have been tackled by previous judgments, notably the question of policy and non-judicial interference. For instance, the right to food, various environmental protection policies. In these cases, the court formulated policies and asked states to implement them. In the migrant workers' case, though it made the unfortunate presumption that the government is the best judge of the situation, the suo motu recognition of the issue by the court also came too late. Instead, the high courts came across as islands of rationality, courage, and compassion in these times, asking questions about migrant rights. Contrast this with the Supreme Court's reaction to the bizarre claim of the Solicitor General, who argued that the exodus of workers was due to fake news. The court accepted this, and media houses were advised to report more responsibly. Our Supreme Court today, sadly, has time for a $1 billion Indian cricket administration or the grievances of a high-profile journalist, but studiously ignored the real plight of millions of migrants who do not have either the money or the profile to compete for precious judicial time with other litigants.